Pop epoxy. And I really couldn't give a good answer because I had never used it.
Sorry.
But Mike and the people over at Countertop Stonecoat Countertop were super sweet and sent me a review box. So I get to review it and I'm so excited about it. So they sent me this much of this stuff and they formulated this artist focused resin instead of it being like for countertops or floors or walls or industrial type things. They came out with a resin specifically for artists.
I mean artists.
One day we'll have our own resin.
Coincidence? Maybe.
Freudian slip? Of course. They also sent me some...
There's a new rag there.
Thank you. Metallics that look pretty bomb as well.
They look pretty dense. Like they look like they're going to go on pretty good.
I'm going to use Blue Earth. But they're all kind of like colors on the same like tonal scale. Tonal scale? Is that a word? I don't know if that's a word. Okay. So I'm going to use that and some of the Just Resin colors that we haven't used yet. Because I want to see how the Stone Coat powders, since they don't have that many, I want to see how they work with other brand colors and things like that. So we're going to use that and something. Oh. And these other Just Resin colors. So I have 2 1/4 gallons. So I guess that makes half a gallon. Half a gallon. 64 ounces. And this is
18 by 36.
One of the largest canvases I've solo poured on, so half nervous, half excited. B, how much resin do you think it will take to cover this Mama Jam?
Shy wants to buy the colors that we used last night. We'll go over that. Shy, remind us at the end of this, okay? This product review is for Stone Coat Countertops!
Also, I don't have Just Resin paints for sale. You have to go to the Just Resin website.
Yeah. One day we will probably
distribute some. Hopefully we can come to a negotiation sooner rather than later, and it'll be amazing. B, how much paint should I put into this? I mean, resin should I use?
Elisa, this is for you.
That's what she said.
Move, go lay down.
Yes, simply, it's in Oregon, I believe. They're from Oregon.
Is it?
Yeah.
So, it's a 2-part resin, so it means 1-to-1.
It's an 18 by 36. It's a big piece.
They are in Grants Pass, Oregon. They have their phone number on the bottle, along with warnings, don't drink it. It says 1-to-1, mix thoroughly for 2 minutes. Pour as soon as mixed.
Pamela, it's Stone Coat Countertops Artist Resin Review.
Mix resin and hardener if left in a mixing cup beyond 5 minutes. Might begin to heat up. Avoid breathing vapors. Dry to touch within 24 hours. Light use 72 hours. Fully cured.
Thanks, Mama Bear.
In 7 days.
So it sounds like it might drive a little slow. We'll see.
Basically, it says what most other resins say. Don't ever smell resin, but I'm doing this to convey to y'all that I don't smell anything in this bottle. And I don't smell anything in this bottle. B, how much resin did you say?
I didn't. Did I?
I don't. Okay. So how much resin do you think?
high sub, Andrew. 22 ounces for 18 by 36. That's what...
22 ounces?
I would say... I would just start out with a...
This is a 16 ounce.
Yeah, I would just start out with... Well, what are you going to do? Are you going to do a negative? Are you going to do a...
Probably.
Just...
I don't know. Initially, I'm going to do a negative, but y'all know how that
goes. How many colors are you going to use?
Five?
I would do the whole...
16. I would just do 16. Gotcha. So, for 16 ounces, that means I go...
We're going to do 16 ounces, guys.
We're going to start with it. It is not cold here, and I will tell you that this is pretty thick.
Andrew says, what are you doing?
Painting.
We're going to do a resin review from Stone Coat Countertops out of Oregon. They sent us some product, and we're going to check it out.
This is some pretty thick stuff. So my initial feeling on this is that I would love to use it for a geode. And also, it
may
thin out a lot once you put the hardener in it. Yeah, the hardener is a lot thinner, and it will probably...
Like I would let it stop and just let it catch up, because you never know. Look at that. Is it separating?
Yeah, because the hardener is so much lighter.
Wow.
And I'm pretty sure typically you're supposed to put the hardener in first. But
well, sometimes hardener is thicker, right? I don't know. Sweet pea, drink some rum and it might improve.
So
Passion Lotus gave 102 happy faces. We'll take that.
I love happy faces.
You can cash that in for a rainy day. That's today.
It is kind of rainy here.
I sure can. I'm going to have to show you kind of up close here. Very shiny, very brilliant, very textured. It's hard to, it's really difficult to see all the details, but those teals, that blue diamond, I can't even tell you, that silver and the white just all go amazing with it. We'll have to put it, one second, y'all. I'll show you some light on it.
I'm just mixing this. I won't do anything crazy.
Like, the texture in this is nuts. Hey, Molly, thank you for that $20 donation. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Molly.
That is the rum we're trying tonight from Ocean, from Hawaii. It's all the way from Hawaii. You can see the little sticker. I'm about ready to try this, the white. We tried the dark.
It's good, spicy.
There you go, she's back. It's a little vanilla-y, what it is. The dark rum. A little vanilla.
So you guys, It is definitely a thicker consistency resin, and I am really, really looking forward to using this for my geodes because, as you know, one of the things you really want to shoot for when doing geodes is lines that'll hold to each other so that you don't have too much bleeding, and a thicker resin or resin that cures quicker facilitates that.
The painting behind E's right elbow looks like a half of Three Musketeers' face. The pink one.
The smoker?
Oh, yeah. We call that one the smoker. He's doing a little toki toki, I think, is what he's got going on right there.
So, I'm trying to follow the directions to a T, and it says get it out of this bucket within the first 5 minutes. So, I'm going to do that. The reason why that is the resin, this is the eScience version. Resin will play off of each other, generate more.
If you're going to do a negative, I wouldn't put that much in.
Okay.
You're not going to want to use that, like a bunch of colors, if it's going to be negative space.
You're right.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I always think that. I always think, okay, well, I'm going to fill it up this much, but if you're just going to do, especially that many colors, bang.
It's thinner. I got a little bit too.
She got white happy.
And squirted.
You might want to hit that button.
That's what she said.
Jess Resin is in the house.
Hi, Jess Resin.
Where did they come in at? Oh, there they are. Hey, guys, we just showed the piece. I don't know if you guys got to see it. No. We'll show them after. I don't want to do this in the middle of a Stone Coat advertisement.
It's not an ad, it's just.
It's not an ad.
I mean, you could show. Well,
eh. Y'all, I've been looking forward to using this turquoise since we first got it.
Look how nice everybody is.
Everybody's amazing.
Lynn is turning red.
Because of that joke.
What up with asking?
What up
with asking? Hi, Jess Resin, sippy sippy. Has anybody ordered any coffee mugs? I want to see what the coffee mugs
are. Oh, Laura Taylor got one. She sent me a picture of it when I was walking Cujo.
Oh, and we stopped in. I had to buy a piece of foam board for that sign up there today. And went into Hazel Art Supply. And it sounds like we might be able to put some flyers up in there and get some class. Wait, what are they? Students for resin, because they sell a lot of resin in there, which I was really surprised about. Oh, Andrew, really? Somebody said I didn't ask you.
What?
We do. Whatever you say, Lynn, they can hear you from that mic, just so you know.
Greg says, my son thinks Lynn is cute. Thank you. Wait, which mic can they hear me from?
Yeah, Andrew, if you ask a question or say something and somebody answers with the little blue wrench above their name, it's because we allow them to.
They're a moderator.
They're a moderator. And if anybody else has an answer or can answer something from, you know, anybody, we encourage it if it's a positive or if it's the correct thing, because a lot of people in here know what they're doing. Stirring stuff?
No.
Huh?
No.
That's the fun part of it.
Thanks, Happy Chick. We try. We don't, like we said before, we don't consider ourselves teachers. We just kind of show you where to insert your creativity, basically.
Y'all, this is Blue Earth by...
The Butler Colors. Are you adding blue E?
I added blue...
Carolina wants to know what the working time is for that.
It's comparable to Art Resin. In ideal conditions.
Thanks, Suzanne Brooklyn.
So it's about 45 minutes, I believe I read.
Thanks, Mary Jane.
This Blue Earth is a gorgeous color.
Amy Haas, I'm running low on white epoxy paste. How long does it take?
I'm actually out as well, and I should be getting a case from, not a case, my order in from Australia this week. I talked to Sue the other day, and she said it'll be in this week. The white epoxy paste is in there. So as soon as I get it, three business days at the most.
Just Resin, you're about to get some people buying some colors from you because they're amazing. We don't sell their art paste, paint, or pigments or powders yet, so
you'll have to order from them for now. So you can use a trowel like Mike from Art Resin does. I like to feel how deep the resin is in certain areas, so I just use my hands.
And I think that a trowel would scrape that canvas.
Probably
too,
scratch so. The canvas.
But it's prepped with PPG flat white acrylic house paint, so it's probably pretty durable. I don't think you want to use a trowel with those teeth on it.
And she just wants the finger paint.
Those are the colors.
This is the best work ever. God, thanks, Shy. hopefully, Claire, in the future we will. I think we're going to speak to them this week about it. So far these colors have been, over the top. Like they're very vibrant, very true to what color it shows. A lot of times, some pigments or paste, you put a little bit more in there than you should, and it kind of thins out or it dilutes it or it
turns into marshmallow.
Turns into marshmallow and. So far, yeah, we love it. We love their stuff. Dip Kick Butterflies.
The challenge.
Yeah, that is what you're gonna do if you don't know what a diptych is. Sweet Pea, you basically have two pieces of canvas that are same size, and you make. you make basically one image with both pieces put together. And so I was thinking a butterfly would be amazing because it has two wings. They don't have to match, obviously, because that's pretty much impossible. But
unless you want to do the smush.
Yeah, you could do the smush, which would be fun. That would probably be the only way it would might get some sort of and Lisa, I used, it was called Blue Diamond. That's what that really crazy teal or phthalo blue was with a cobalt blue. PJ said, "Why don't I keep doing this up?" I know, I'm right there with you.
Yeah, I'll get him.
That blows me away that you got just that much to cover that entire canvas.
Sometimes you just have to work with what you got.
Wait, let me see.
Thanks, Leanne, for watching.
Dude, I can get the lawyer too. I'm thinking about making a little bit more because it's kind of thin.
Babe, when you put that all that on there, it's gonna fill out.
Okay. I can look at that. I know. I'll get it later.
Right, you made a lot for each color, right?
I know.
I don't think you're gonna be able to do a negative space.
Probably not.
I would just do just one big.
Is that like a puddle or?
Judy, this week I'm waiting. Nurse calls.
I haven't seen her in a while.
This week I'm mailing out yours, Jeff, and Erica's gift. Wow. Well, Judy, did you see how many colors that she's mixed in? She has all the colors. It's an 18 by 36, Nicole.
That blue is great. What's this point?
I think after
I
this board,
so fast,
we
I
should
miss too much. Thanks, Deborah.
I think after this board, we should all sit around and admire your pour you did last night.
Oh, that one.
Mary Jane, we'd love to see it.
That's what she said.
She just can't let it go.
Can't.
That's what she said.
And that's just, everybody's come through and said, how big is it? And then that's what she said. That's what she said. LOLs. Diane? That is a surprise. She says, what's the new studio number? Judy sent $10.99.
Thanks, Judy. All right, I'm going to... I'm going to blow this around.
Laura says when E4s reminds me of dancing.
Do what?
Laura says when E4s reminds me of dancing.
I am formally trained.
poster.
Not ready for that.
I want to add this one.
This is going to look amazing, I think. I think it's going to be a good one. Eric and Jeff.
Mother of Pearl.
What was that?
Just a cup of sticks.
What, will you read? This is like so far up, I can't see this.
What?
Family Rod.
Eric and Jeff, what would you think of a non-for discussion topic in the Facebook group, a section for people to share other art?
We pretty much allow people to
post.
I mean,
people can already post whatever.
You can show us your artwork. We don't mind at all. I'm sure I'm going to post some of my art in there when I start doing it again. If I do. There have been a couple dozen. That's true. That's very true.
Hi, Ellen. I hope your Yorkie's okay.
Yes,
ma'am. Ellen, do Yorkie's not doing good? He's all on the loose for an hour.
Cujo's done that to me before. Scared the life out of me. I'm pretty sure I've lost a couple years.
Right.
Addiction family. And Leah just gave everyone $10.
Thank you, Leah.
Thank you, Leah.
Well, gave y'all $10.
I'm gonna try this. This has got to be at least. What is that, 80 proof? This has got to be like 151, this rum. It has to be. Oh, babe, that looks great.
No.
Ugh. I can't hear. Are you trying to, I can barely read this. It's up so high, tilted down. So. All right.
Katie, you did not miss much. You just missed an amateur doing a pour, and we just started this one.
You did really good for an amateur.
We are reviewing Stone Coat countertop resin, which seems to be doing very well.
No.
I'm excited to see the sides.
Can we hit this?
Wondering R wants to know if you're using just resin again.
Look at that. No, we are using Stone Coat countertop.
But I am using a few just resin pigments.
Double the percentage to get the proof.
Well.
Bit of science up in you,
Ia. Hey, science.
I'm going to show you what this. Look at this.
I think I'm doing a good assistant.
Very amazing, God is an assistant.
77.5. That's 150 proof. I'm pretty sure that's illegal. I could definitely start a car.
Maybe don't show that on camera.
Dee, watch out for your hair.
Oh, thanks. I always forget that. I need to have a messy bun crew. It's fine.
Oh.
Get it for you.
This tastes like vacation, y'all.
Once I'm done with this, can you fix me up one?
Do what?
Once I'm done with this, can you fix me up one?
Okay.
With less alcohol.
I'm pretty sure you put more of that in there earlier.
No, I made a different glass.
Babe, that, I would, man, what I would do, look at, it's so badass. Take that gold and do that, just this, like a sticky, this a stream, and then a stream, and then do that. Like, so it goes into the negative.
Ugh. I need to, like, finish out this white, because it's still just streamy, you know?
But that's another thing, too, that,
Rotate.
It seems like it's doing really well. Like a lot of times if you heat up resin, it kind of all starts heating up and then it just goes wherever. This looks like it's
thicker.
It's staying.
It's staying where I want it to.
Ellen wants to know what colors you're using right now.
So far, Nancy, we like it. We like that it stays where you don't heat it. Like if you heat it up, it's obviously gonna get a little thinner and move around. And this stuff is staying where it's at. Like it's apparently it's a little thicker, so it's, you know, it's not gonna move as much unless you heat it up. This human bronze, this resin. These are just the pigments. We're using Stone Coat countertop. No, this is not blue sapphire. Blue sapphire is not in there. Is it?
Yeah.
Is that what you're holding?
It doesn't.
Isn't that? Oh.
Yeah, but it doesn't.
I think it's this one.
I think it's that very intense one right there.
Wow, that looks way different. Blue sapphire. Sorry.
What's what?
Laura Smith asked what the pot time is.
And turquoise.
The pot life?
Pot time.
And.
Okay, I want to try it. Can you lift that just a little bit so that this will run?
Very artsy, babe. Very artsy.
Lisa says the blue reminds me of your old favorite Maui from like.
Oh, right?
Nice. I like that.
Look at that white.
Mm-hmm.
That is gorgeous. Angel Heart 444 says it looks beautiful.
Yeah, it's crazy. Like, you put it on there and you try to blow it, it didn't move. Like, you definitely need to heat it up a tad. What is that color you put on there?
That's the Stone Coat color.
This stuff right there?
Mm-hmm.
What is it? This dark.
Oh, here's a good question. Tracy Henry asked, being thicker would be ideal for geodes.
Yes.
There you go.
More bronze?
Yeah. Isn't that what?
Yeah.
I don't know what color is that?
Is this one. Which is also this one. It's so
very
icy.
Transparent, yeah. Well, from here it looks like it's really kind of washed out. Can you, is it, does it feel like it's heating up or any?
No.
Like if you hit over the top of it?
Like, I don't want you to, here, just put your hand over this. There's nothing.
Oh, yeah.
It's just, it's acting as if it's getting hot because it's thicker, but it's not setting. Like, obviously, if it was running at the end of its pot life.
Patty, this is Stone Cold. Hi, Trina. Hi, little peeps. Sorry, I'm late.
We're just glad you're here.
Is that light moving? Oh, it is. Look at that. Man, I like that it does that. I like that it just sits and waits until it's its turn.
Yeah.
This might be the better acting kid of the resins.
This one is not a step kid, seems like, so far.
I know. Lucy, look how they just keep, like, these just keep, like...
Growing?
Growing. And she hasn't done anything to those. Well, I'm gonna let you guys see this. It's like a river of white.
Everyone's saying how stunning it is.
Oh, thanks, y'all.
I wanna do one with this.
If I drop one more ever-loving thing.
Oh, poor Ursha. Yeah, I'm not picking that one up. Sorry, I'll be... That's my son.
You're gonna... I did not.
It's very artsy. That's great, babe. Just Resin said that is beautiful.
Sorry, Diane. What's the question?
That should be an Angel Soft commercial.
Y'all, I don't know what is my problem. I can't hold on to...
Somebody said they dropped 80 ounces of resin tonight.
I would cry.
What?
I would still be crying.
Your floor would be extremely beautiful.
Yes, Simply Shabby, the cells don't need an additive. It's forming because of the paint and how it's reacting weight-wise with the other colors. Okay. Erica, this is now 10 for 3 years. Well done, thank you. I feel like I should pull something out this way just a little.
Do it. I would do like a quick one and then just blow it. Heat it up and blow it.
I think the brassy color or...
Maybe the blue sapphire and then brass. If anybody's interested in this amazing first time piece using stone coat is for sale.
Look how many passes it takes for it to ignite. I like that about it because it gives me more control over what moves, you know?
I would go that way. Or just out maybe. Yeah, in places. And then Alan Pearson says, where do you order stone coat?
They have a website?
They have a website. Is it on the bottle? Let's see here, kids. There it is. Boccia. StoneCoatCountertops.com. It's definitely good for artists. We were surprised. Monee. M-O-N-E-E. Welcome to the fam. Kathleen, what we did is I sanded it first with like a 220 and then took a roller and put some flat white house paint, just rolled it, made it nice and smooth, let it dry, and then sanded it with 400. And you can also spray the back with warm water and that'll definitely stiffen up the canvas as well. And the house paint really makes it a more stiffer canvas so it doesn't pool in the middle.
Welcome, Golden Vision.
And yes, there is a cat. He's mine.
Well, this is the first time we use this, so we have to let it dry, Trina, and see, you know, what it's like. Because a lot of resins have a different, you know, 1 day, 2 day, 8 hour, you know, 3 day curing time.
I can actually tell you that it's on the bottle.
I think this one says it takes 7 days to completely cure, so.
7 days, yeah.
It's like you could touch it after 24 hours, light use after 72 hours, and then full use after a week, I believe.
But it can take up to 30 days before reaching maximum durability and stuff.
Hey, Greg. Trina, they actually have a durability video on their website. Nope, their YouTube channel. And you can see first-hand durability there. I didn't know Pi was such a chatterbox.
I'm sorry.
Pretty stoked about how this turned out, y'all.
I'm digging it.
Pretty pumped about it, y'all. Trina, shoot me an email and we can talk about...
Okay, I'm gonna go to
what is he talking to?
He's just talking. Cat's nuts. Just, like, go off.
He wants to play fetch.
Cats are crazy.
Alright, I'm gonna put this Mama Jam.
Wow, Pamela said.
To bed.
I miss my cats, but luckily they lived a long life. 17, 19, and 16 years. Wow. Happy Chick says, was 16 ounces enough?
Yeah. I actually have resin left. Chatterbox needs to not be around the resin.
Yeah, taking it away.
Hopefully. Give me some gloves. No, give me some of that paper up there. I'm gonna tape a little door to that.
Oh, not me, you can finish filling the babies over there.
Lynn, are you on reading duty?
Yeah.
Do some.
Is the extra pen this cut then? Because Gesso isn't strong enough?
You say Gesso?
English bad. I don't speak.
It is your first and only language. Well, the only reason why I say it is because one of my favorite YouTubers, Anne-Marie Ritterhoff, says Gesso. She is from Holland. What was the question?
Is the extra canvas prep done because it's not strong enough?
The thing about gesso is that...
See, I don't know. That's one thing Judy said, that you can put it on the back. But I've never tried to, like...
Wait.
I always used it to make it...
We froze.
Oh. Thank you.
I always tried to use it to make it smooth, and it just felt like...
Okay, we're good.
Wasn't enough. But that was, you know, 10, 20 years ago.
This color from Stone Coat is really pretty. This like icy platinum blue color. Tomorrow's pour, I'm gonna use all Stone Coat colors. Now that I see how well the Stone Coat pigments work with other pigments that we use. Which I knew it would, but I just wanted to see. Cujo, wait. He's ready to go outside. No, you're fine, just wait.
I miss the animal master over here. The kitty is named Perio Raymond, or Popeye for short. Oh, he's licking me.
He does that. He's gonna get hot and wanna get down. Heads up.
I have to be careful because I forget you can't just drop dogs.
No.
Pujo's ready to go outside and I'm ready to rob them colors. Jeff, what top shall I get for the black and white Montana blackout paints? And where do I find them?
It's you.
Well, just go.
Okay.
Tamara, you might have to find them online unless you have like a skateboard shop or a vape shop or a head shop. Or if your local art supply store, it has to be like a real...
Not a craft store.
Yeah, not a craft store. I normally get like the yellow New York Thins or the German Thins. It really depends on what you want to do with them.
What's your goal?
Can't hear Jeff at all.
That's probably because this is so loud.
Rachel, we don't prime the coasters. They're just, is the mic on?
Marcy, please don't take my cat. I'm so sorry he's loud. What are the things
they not hear?
What?
What are the things you're saying the coasters on?
Cake snakes. Can y'all hear okay?
All right, sounds good, Tamara.
Not unclear.
That's right, Kimmy.
Then it's just noisy, then it's hard to hear.
Oh, gotcha.
No climbing to the coasters? Rachel is asking about.
Jeff just answered.
No, we don't prime the coasters.
They're in the Amazon box. Well, they're in our Amazon link in the description box.
Looks like colored lava.
It's so pretty.
Really wish you could see in person what these things actually look like. I love hearing that when people buy our artwork from
Mary Jane, it's
online.
No, I'm not pouring tonight. What is the that light ice blue? That's Stone Colts.
That is a Stone Coat.
Stone
it's right
Coat.
There.
It's this from Stone Coat right here.
It's a gorgeous, gorgeous color, y'all.
Blue Earth Metallic. And look at the work time, you guys. She's still working with this stuff. Like,
this video's been going for
ages.
I don't even know.
53 minutes. So far we've got an hour.
And it's still not, like, in the cup, it's not even getting hot yet.
Yeah.
So I'm sure I could have worked with this easily over an hour. Will you pull out that stack of trays? Oh, no. Nope. Yep.
Oh, fun. My cup is barking with moo.
That moon's ready to go for sure.
Alright, so I'm going to show them this piece. Here you guys. I'm going to show you, if you guys wanted to see the piece from last night. Piece that I did last night. With just resin pigments.
And that's wet.
It's hard to not make a shadow or a reflection.
Not that I'm able.
Yeah.
most of the time. You can also use a torch.
Is there a difference between them?
A heat gun has airflow, whereas a torch is just heat. So if you don't want your painting to move, you know, we blow the heat gun on it and it pushes it.
Mm-hmm.
If you only want to pop the bubbles, then use a torch. Someone asked about what this one turned out like.
Oh. That's what that looks like.
It stayed fairly well. We need to finish it. I need to patch this spot where I rubbed alcohol on the black painting background. And we still need to finish the detail in the teeth and put a shadow under this part, but pretty stoked with the idea that I can paint with resin.
You guys missed this, but she painted it with a paintbrush. Just kind of took it out of the cup and painted it. Shy, if you want to buy it, I will never sell it to anybody but you.
Someone's going to get it.
Someone one day.
Well, if your enthusiasm about it. And not everyone wants to have it.
Deborah, we're going to do the floor in Judy's studio soon. You guys should do a class on paintbrush. Like for with resin or all, like just regular paintbrush painting. Thank you, Shy. Here, man.
Oh, that's what we need to do. I guess we could put it up there. We can put a piece of Velcro, like right above the artist till death for the, put a piece of Velcro either there or there. And then put
the hashtag for the pour.
The hashtag for the challenge.
Yeah.
That'll be fun.
Kelly's asking about the Darth Vader piece. What it's about.
Oh, that is Vader. Darth Vader. That's a James Bond. It's a James Bond Vader. That is a 24x48 spray paint stencil that I did. And yes, he's for sale. It's on a gallery wrap canvas. It's a one of a kind. One off.
A kind.
Vader. Darth Vader. And he is for sale.
Elisa, I do believe they are selling the resin. It should be on the website. The difference between countertop epoxy and resin is it's ultimately the same thing, but countertop epoxy usually goes through a stress test where it's put up against heat and distress type situations to make sure that it can actually be used on a countertop. For instance, I would never put art resin on a countertop. It's a softer kind of resin, so it would not be very effective as a countertop.
Lucy, we have not sold the girls. They're in the hallway in the gallery area where we're gonna put them up for display. We could put sold on it by a correct private collector. I've always wanted to do that.
Sure can, Diane. Night, Shelley.
Is the countertop resin also food safe?
Not necessarily. Some are FDA.
For countertop.
But
stone coat, maybe.
The thing is, most food safe resins just mean that it can come into contact with food, not that you should just keep it on there like a cheese tray and leave the cheese on it for a really extended amount of time. They don't have the art coat on the website yet. Okay, I will find out and link it in the description box. I'll call Mike tomorrow and find out. Hi, Robin Chang. Bye, Just Resin.
Thanks for joining us, Just Resin. Thank you very much.
Kelly Green wants to know, what about the sexy stormtrooper? Was that your idea?
Yes, that was done in all charcoal on a 24x48 canvas as well. There's actually three sexy Star Wars characters, there's a sexy Vader, a sexy Boba Fett, and a sexy trooper. And they're all different, completely, like, different.
Yeah. Amy, we do sometimes do multiple layers. Diane, I will text you.
Rob wants to know your thoughts on the stone cold process. No product.
We love the way it flows. We love the way it acts when you don't heat it up and when you do heat it up. A lot of resins kind of act all the same. Like, you heat it up and it stays liquid, and it kind of just makes everything else liquid.
So I'll tell you that this Stone Coat countertop is much thicker than the resins that I've used before. It didn't really have a smell to it. It took a little bit more muscle to mix it together because it is thicker, but I really like it. I'm going to definitely be investing in this art coat. I don't have the prices, and I don't have a link down below, but I will also be using this resin tomorrow, and I will include in that video and this video pricing and a link for this resin. I really like it. I'm going to use it for my next geode for sure because its viscosity is amazing. I kept it in these little cups for an hour almost. It didn't heat up and start to harden at all. I love it. I'm definitely going to be using it again. Barb, I would not resin over an oil painting. As you know, oil paints never really, really dry. That's why you never see fancy oil paintings with glass over it, because it would condensate. I don't know if that's a word. I may have made that up. And sweat on the inside.
10%.
Thank you, Diane. You could absolutely do that, Deborah. We can help you as much as we can. We've never done a floor. We will be doing Judy's probably over Thanksgiving. Anyways, my phone's at 10%. Cujo's going to bite my ankles off if we don't say goodbye. Don't forget to join our ATD's Poor People group. We have a challenge in there right now for a diptych butterfly. We will post an example of a diptych that Jeff has done before. Our business page is Thornton Artist Till Death. Our website is Artist Till Death. .com. We have the stir sticks, the mystery boxes, artist who paints, all available there. If you have any questions, please email us at thornartisttilldeath.com. If you want to send us snail mail, ATD Studios, 1409 South Lamar Street, Dallas, Texas, 75215. And our Instagram is Artist Till Death Studios. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Oh, also Teespring, search Artist Till Death Studios. You can find our merch. This is not our merch. We were sent these today. The letter's in there from who it's from. Yeah. Yeah. She also sent us her business card. Love your idea. Use them as business cards. You guys are bananas. Christine Keyworth. This coaster is beautiful. This is a bananas idea. She sent Jeff and I matching banana shirts. Y'all, I have so much banana gear. So I have like 4 shirts and I love them all super, super much.
And a big banana in the corner.
It's all great. We love you guys. And we'll see you, Mignana, for another Stone Coat review. Bye.
I said bye.
You ready to done this? Let's go outside.